We can go pick up the phone and talk to somebody who's been in rock and roll for the longest time. She's known for hits as... And of course, then there was... Then, after gazillions of awards, movies, world tours, books, Broadway plays, she decided to make a dance album. She and I got together 2 years ago to collaborate on our current album, Bring You to the Brink. She also collaborated with George Morell in Washington, D.C., with Basement Jacks in the U.K., and with Axwell in Sweden. And now the album Bring You to the Brink, which starts out with the song that Cyndi and I did called High and Mighty, is nominated for a Grammy for Dance Album of the Year. I'm very thrilled to catch up with this person on the phone in my own show. Welcome, Cyndi Lauper.
Hey, how are you?
Very good, thank you. It's been over a year and a half since you and I started working on this project. And I have to say, props for making the decision to make an electronic album and it resulting immediately in a Grammy nomination for Best Dance Album. So first off, congratulations on that.
Oh, no, thank you. Listen, so many people tell me about High and Mighty. One girl, she came up to me and she said, listen, that's my go-out music. High and Mighty, it's my theme song. It's pretty great that a lot of people responded to High and Mighty, too. I just wanted to let you know.
Thanks so much for that. I know that some of the other people that worked with you on this album had a great time as well. I want to talk about Us, and Us is the people on the electronic production side of this album, like Axwell and Basement Jacks and Richard Morell, myself. We all learned a lot from working with you. Is there anything that you learned from us guys?
Tons. As a whole, all you guys and yourself were very generous to let me into your studio to work and kind of share your process with me. What struck me about your work was that it was riff-orientated.
It's riff-oriented.
No, riff, yeah. And we were talking when I met you of how blues was also very riff-orientated, and I thought it would be very interesting to write lyrics like blues, but not to sing them passionately.
Absolutely.
And so the combination of that was so compelling and interesting as a singer and an artist. I tried to find as many people who were doing things that I could relate to, but that I hadn't already done.
So then when the album is done and it's 99% computers and bleeps and samples and all that kind of stuff, how do you introduce that concept to your band and take it on the road?
I tried to do it with my live band and do everything live. But I didn't feel that work because the rock music sounded great with one group of musicians, and then the dance music, it was always just, you know, you have to have the track. I figured, you know, if I had a few elements like drums, the DJ's front and center, and keyboards attached to that, and then the guitar player in the back, and the roaming singer, and the drummer. And that's it.
Yeah.
And the track is king. It was so exciting.
So this is an example when you do your classic songs in the context of an electronic live set. Do you also turn it around sometimes when you play the songs from this album, from the electronic album, but you play them completely unplugged or acoustically with a completely different musical setting? Do you do that?
Yeah, I used to sing Rain on Me with nothing, just a cappella.
So you've done that already?
Yeah.
And did it work?
Well, I think you got to be fearless. You can't play it safe all the time, especially in dance music. I don't see the safety net.
I agree. And in the dance music scene, and especially lately, there is no safety net.
Well, it got wild again.
We like
and
it wild.
When it gets wild, I'm in.
Well, I find it very inspiring that after all that you've accomplished in your career, everything you've done, you still choose to go out on the stage without a safety net. That is something I think everyone can learn from. And so, all in all, very much deserved the Grammy nomination this year.
And we were so lucky that everything kind of fell into place for that to happen.
Cyndi, thank you so much for taking the time to do a little chat on Glam Scum this week. And for the Grammys, much luck.
Thank you.
We recorded the song in New York City about a year and a half ago. It was the beginning of the entire project, and it ended up as the opener of the album, Bring It to the Brink. This is High and Mighty on Glam Scum International.
How do you see yourself inside your mind? Do you just a step out of time. If I had a dollar every time I tried, I'd be living high and mighty. How do you see yourself inside your mind? Who do you look at when you close your eyes? If I had a dollar every time I cried, I'd be living high and mighty.
Keep the door locked closed. Yeah.